Hey, what's up, guys? In this video, I want to compare two big wholesalers, BJ's and Costco, and try and figure out which one is a better investment. I plan on looking at their balance sheets, looking at their profitability, looking at their segment sales, and then doing a discounted cash flow analysis. Finally, I'll try and check on the insider trading, see if we can learn anything from that, and I'll give you guys my final thoughts on which one is a better investment right now. If you're new to the channel, my name is Dan. I'm a business school professor who's very interested in accounting and finance topics. So if you're into that kind of thing, hit that subscribe button. Let's jump into it. All right, so you guys pretty much know their business, but here is BJ's revenue by segment. You've got edible grocery at 24% and perishables at 27%, and then non-edible grocery coming in at 21%. The rest of it is a mix of some other things. You know, if you've ever been into BJ's, they do sell a lot of non-food items. That's general merchandise there. They also sell gasoline and other services like that, accounting for about 13%. Costco categorizes their products a little differently. You can see food and sundries is just one big category at 42%. You've also got fresh foods and grain there at 14%. So collectively, the edible things there are going to be worth about 56% of Costco's revenues. The rest of it comes from some interesting areas. You've got soft lines there, like apparel and small appliances. You've got hard lines, which means major appliances, electronics, all the beauty products and garden stuff you normally see at Costco. And then they're actually very similar to BJ's in their ancillary and other category, includes gas and pharmacy and things like that, coming in at 16%, very similar to BJ's. Okay, so let's compare the two companies' balance sheets. I see that BJ's is much more highly leveraged with a liabilities to assets ratio of 96%. That is pretty darn high, and you really got to account for that in your model. When you try to value BJ's, you got to understand they're pretty high risk. Costco's leverage ratio is not bad. It's really not in the danger zone. And with their proven record of generating cash flows, I'm really not too concerned about Costco there. As far as the liquidity, you know, clearly BJ's is in a rough spot here, particularly when you look at that quick ratio. Remember, the quick ratio just takes your current assets, not including inventory, and divides it by current liabilities. So BJ's is really running it close there. They really can only cover, 15% of their current liabilities with the current assets on hand, excluding inventory. You know, Costco's numbers are pretty low too, but they are a retailer. They're normally low. I really think BJ's has a lot more concerning things going on here. You can also see BJ's interest expense here is equal to about, 1/7 of the money they generate. And that's concerning if they cannot grow their income. You know, that is pretty concerning there. Another thing we've got going on is BJ's is more asset intensive. You see their long-term assets there, close to 71% of all their assets. Costco, just the opposite. In fact, close to a quarter of all of Costco's assets are inventory, and another quarter is just cash. So they are very liquid. All right, so here's a DuPont analysis, which is a way to look at a company's profitability. I like to use at least 3 or 4 years. Otherwise, you can get a pretty misleading picture. Now, if you don't know much about DuPont analysis, check out my video in the description below. But all I'm gonna do is break down their return on equity into its three parts. And that way we can learn how they make their money. Now let's look at Costco first, because that one's easier to understand. Costco is more stable, as you know. They've been around a lot longer. They have pretty consistent return on equity, anywhere from 23 to 28%. So you know what you're going to get there. Now, how do they generate such good return on equity? Well, they have a pretty pathetic net income margin by normal standards. For retailers, this is actually not bad. This is all right, coming in at about 2.5% in the most recent year. That means for every dollar they sell, they get to generate 2.5 cents of profit. Again, pathetic compared to a lot of companies, but for retailers, that is totally normal. And you see retailers have that incredible asset turnover. So they generate lots of sales with very few assets. You can see, you know, their asset turnover is anywhere between 3 and 4. So for every dollar of assets they have in place, they generate anywhere from $3 to $4 of sales every year. And that's really how they make their profit there. They do have an equity multiplier of close to 3 because they are, you know, decently leveraged, but they also have just a nice business. Let's look at BJ's, which is a little weird here. You see negative ROE, even though they're clearly having positive margins, they're generating lots of sales. What's going on here, guys, is you have a negative equity multiplier. Remember, that equity multiplier is assets divided by your equity. That's a way to capture how much debt you have. The thing is, for BJ's, they have negative equity right now. They have negative retained earnings because of some of the losses they generated in their early years. So it ends up being a negative ROE, but I wouldn't look at it that way at all. I would view it as, you know, just take the absolute value. It's just a fluke because you got negative equity. So with that in mind, I see their margins are increasing every year, coming in at 2.5% most recently. I like to see that. I mean, I wonder how high they can get those margins. Asset turnover is incredible, although it really went down this past year. I really hate to see that. And I'm actually pretty shocked about that because we had a pandemic. I would think people would be grocery shopping for sure. But yeah, they have incredible return on equity because, of course, they have super high leverage. But we have to keep in mind that their leverage is really what's driving it right now. Okay, so before we dive into a deep valuation, let's just have a quick look. BJ's right now, the market says they're worth about $5.25 billion. There is incredible amount of short interest in BJ's right now. I do find that concerning. You know, when you short sell a company, you're at pretty significant risk there. You know, you can lose infinite amount of money, as anyone who ever short sold Tesla realizes. So the fact that their short interest is so high is concerning to me. Maybe some people out there know something that we don't. The PE ratio, of course, is very attractive. You're paying, you know, 12.6 times their earnings at this current price. And those earnings are expected to grow. BJ's is a growing company right now. So, you know, you can get a growth firm for a PE ratio of 12. That's incredible. Now with Costco, they're a much safer investment. They're not going to go bankrupt. There's no risk of that, really. So for them, you know, you got a significant premium here. You got to pay about close to 37 times Costco's earnings to own shares of Costco right now. And they have had incredible growth, but with a market cap of $164 billion and so many stores already, you know, across the world, they're really not forecasted to grow much in the coming years. So that is quite a premium to pay, but you do get a lot of safety with Costco. Okay, so after looking at both companies' balance sheets, comparing their profitability, and just knowing a little bit about where they generate their revenues, what I can say is that both companies seem like attractive companies to be invested in. Costco seems like the much more stable company, the larger company, the safer company, whereas BJ's is just a growth company right now, but has incredible potential. The question really is, given their current prices, are you going to make money investing in either of these companies? And that's what we really care about as investors. And so right now, I'm going to use discounted cash flow analysis to try and figure out which one's a better investment. To do that for BJ's is going to be really hard. BJ's margins are changing every year. You saw they went from 1% to 2.5% in the past 3 years. And I don't know where they're going to end up at. I have to try and forecast that based on the industry averages. The industry average for retailers is about 4.29%. So I could use that number or make it slightly lower, being that they are a membership club type retailer. I also have to try and anticipate how much BJ's is going to be able to grow in the coming years. They have a lot of room for growth. They have about a $5 billion market cap compared to Costco with $163 billion. So BJ's has room to run, but how much are they going to grow every year? I have to try and figure that out. So I kind of have to have a vision for what they're going to become and how they're going to get there. And it's going to be pretty complicated. So that valuation will be tough. Costco's will be relatively simple. Costco's got that long operating history. I pretty much know the kind of margins they generate every year. At this point, they're so big, I can look at analyst forecasts. You get tons of analyst forecasting, so you can get a pretty good estimate of their growth in the next couple of years. So let's get into it though. Let's see what each one is worth. Okay, so here is the revenue growth that analysts are forecasting for BJ's. You've got incredible growth this past year, but after that, they really aren't expecting really nice growth. As you can see here, you know, negative 2%, 5.5%, 7.3%, 4.88%. So we're going to kind of take an average of that and say, you know, maybe 5%. So look, I'll be generous. I'll give them 5% growth for the next 10 years, suppose. And we're starting with our base year. We know the revenues we got that year. We're going to say 5% growth after that. I also have to forecast how the margins will change, which is pretty unknown at this point. I'll be optimistic. I'm going to say they can increase those margins all the way to 3.5%. Remember, the industry average is 4.29. But, you know, importantly, their main competitor, Costco, can only seem to get 2.5% margins. So I'll kind of go in between those. I'll say 3.5. I also have to forecast their reinvestments. So in the early years, I'm going to assume they're going to have to take a lot of that money they make and reinvest it back into the business to fuel that growth and to also, quite frankly, pay some of that debt back. So if they're able to do this, I assume, you know, an 80% reinvestment rate going down to 70 and then, you know, eventually kind of leveling off at 28%, which is pretty typical for a mature business. And the result of all this math is a stream of free cash flows they're going to generate. All we have to do next is discount these cash flows back to present value, add up the terminal value, and figure out the value for the company stock. Okay, so what I'm doing here is I got that stream of free cash flows to equity. I then discount them back to their present value using a 9% discount rate. Now, why so high given the low interest rate environment right now? Well, as you saw with their balance sheet and being a smaller company, BJ's is definitely a little bit riskier. I think 9% is appropriate. So here's the total firm value then. These are in millions, by the way. You got $46 million of cash on hand. You got about $1.7 billion made up of the free cash flows over the next 10 years. And then, of course, the terminal value, $3.4 billion. You end up with a company that's worth about $5.1 billion, meaning about $37.49 per share. So given their current share price, it doesn't look very attractive right now. So here are revenue forecasts for Costco. And you can see, even though they're so much larger, they're actually expected to be growing at a higher rate over the next couple of years. I'll just take a rough average. I think about 8% growth over the next 5 years is reasonable. And I'm going to use that in my calculations. Okay, so here is a scenario for Costco. We've got the revenue growth there at 8%. And I assume it drops to about 5% for the 5 years after that. You know, companies can't grow at the same rate forever. They normally have diminishing growth, and Costco is already quite large. Net income margin, I will assume that Costco can actually increase that, although not all the way to 4%. I do think their main advantage is their cost. If you've ever tried their products, I think you would agree, you know, cost is the main reason people shop there. So using that information, I get net income. And after net income, I then want to figure out the free cash flows to the equity holders. I need to figure out a reinvestment rate. Based on historical averages, based on the fact that they're so mature, I'm going to use a pretty low reinvestment rate, assuming they do not need to buy additional stores, you know, not too many anyway. They don't have any R&D, so, you know, just 20%, maybe dropping all the way to 10% after that. Okay, so here's what we got for Costco. We've got a stream of free cash flows to equity holders. I'm going to discount them to their present value using a 6.1% discount rate, which seems more appropriate for Costco given the lower risk of those cash flows. If I add them all up, here's my total firm value. You got $14 billion cash on hand, plus all the money you're going to get over the next 10 years, plus the terminal value. So you add them all up, the company is probably worth about $171 billion, or about $386 per share. Given their current share price, technically it's undervalued, but it's not undervalued by very much. All right, guys. So here are my final thoughts on BJ's and Costco. Number one, Costco is a whole lot safer. BJ's has a lot of business risk. They're very likely to, you know, run into some financial distress. They're at risk of going out of business possibly, given their high debt ratios and their low liquidity. That being said, I'm very impressed with the improvement in BJ's profit margins. I like their return on equity. It's absolutely sick. You know, as far as their valuation with BJ's, you know, to me, you got a company that's growing. It's priced at about 12.6 times its earnings, and it has a very, very good return on equity. So on the surface, it's a good deal, but, you know, considering that risk, I think fair is fair. I think the price is fair, and, you know, it's high risk, high reward with BJ's. And I think you saw that with a discounted cash flow analysis where we used a higher discount rate for BJ's and the price turned out to be about what it's trading for right now. You know, fair is fair. And I think the same for Costco. Costco is very low risk, but it's very low reward at this point. You know, some of the early investors in Costco have enjoyed incredible gains, but going forward at the price it's at right now, you're not going to be among them if you buy them at this price. So to me, Costco is a low risk, low reward. And you know, would I consider adding either to my portfolio? Probably not. But I wouldn't fault someone for adding Costco if that's what they want to do. You know, just don't expect good returns. Just expect to have a stable, low return. And for BJ's, if anybody wants to bet on BJ's, you know, I wouldn't fault them for that either. It's just high risk to me, so I'm not going to do it. But that's just my opinion. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Thank you for watching.